list data structure, right? Last time we saw what is list, then how to create list, then we saw how to add items in the list, insert item, how to add one list inside another list by using extend, then searching any element, counting, traversing. Okay, few more things about list is remaining that we'll discuss today. Next is, the last time about searching and all we saw. Searching for that index method was there. Then finding out how many times the element occurs, the count method we saw last time. Finding minimum, maximum, that was function min, function max. So I hope you remember all that things. Few more about list. Next one method we have to see, that is sort. Okay, so it will arrange all the elements of your list in ascending order by default. It will change your list itself. It will not return you a new sorted list. The list itself is what? Change. So it is going to arrange all the elements of your list in ascending order by default. Okay, and suppose if you pass this parameter reverse equal to true, which is by default false, but if you give reverse equal to true, then it will arrange your list in descending order. And arranging the elements in ascending order or descending order, that process only is called as sorting. Actually, sorting means process of arranging elements in a group in some manner. Okay, so that arranging process in some manner is only actually called as sorting. Okay, to sort the given list in ascending order, default it's going to do ascending. Why? Because this reverse is equal to false. But if you pass this reverse flag as true, then it is going to arrange all your elements in descending order. Okay, see, it is going to modify the list itself. A equal to, this is your list, A dot sort, print and see. A itself is modified. It's not going to return your copy. It is a in-place sorting. In-place sorting meaning the original array, in the original array itself, the sorting takes place. Okay. So when you print and see your list, now it will be in ascending order by default. But when I give reverse equal to true, then it's going to arrange the list in descending order. Clear? So it will give you 6, 12, 23, 24, 67, 89. And when I give reverse equal to true, so it's going to arrange in reverse order. Clear? See, I'll give you one example. Quickly we'll see the demonstration of it. Lot of methods are there, only the main thing is you have to use it. Clear? Once you start using it in your applications, you come to know. Now 3.10 release also has come. Now when I told you the installation process, I guess when your class started, so in the first or second lecture I showed you the installation of Python. That time you people installed the latest one, that was 3.9. Now 3.10 is also available. And for your information, in 3.10 some more features they have added. Python people have added some more features, like they have introduced switch case also. Getting? Means till now they were not adding switch case because they took some poll also on it. Is switch case needed to be put in Python? So the poll came that there is no need, we can do it with if else. But now in the latest 3.10 they have added one concept called switch case, but not word switch, they have used word match. Internally it is very much similar. That is just for your information. Getting? I just wanted to tell you that. So if possible, you can install and see 3.10 also. L equal to, suppose this is list, will create list of strings, suppose. And And now if I write L dot sort, clear? See, L dot sort, when we wrote, it didn't return anything. That is none. Means L itself is sorted. Now you can check L. Is it sorted? Alphabetically, I guess B comes first, then H, then J, then R, S, T, and T. And if I write S dot L dot sort and reverse equal to true, suppose if I give. Getting? So print L. Now it is in reverse order. Okay. Now on the slide, I haven't given about the method which I'm going to tell you. Method ni function. About a function called sorted. There is one function also. Like in the last lecture, we saw one function min, max. It was a built-in function. So same way, sorted function is also present. Only the difference is, it returns you a copy in which sorted elements are there. The original list remains same. Getting? That is the difference. Like suppose this is your list, and if I write print sorted of L, so it will return you a new list in which all the elements are sorted. Getting? But if you print and see your original list, it is as it is. Getting? No? It is as it is, whatever was previously the list. Getting? So only that is the difference between sorted and sort. Sort is a method of list class. Sorted is a built-in function. And second, sorted does in-place sorting. That is, it does sorting in the original list. Sorted returns a new list which is sorted. The original list remains same. Getting? So only that, just remember, because everything I cannot provide on the slide. Just while teaching you, I give you this information. Remember it. Okay. Then next we have reverse method. If you want to change the internal order of your list, internal order means you want to make the first element as the last, second as second last, third as third last, then you can use reverse method. So reverse method changes the internal order of element. Okay. And what does it makes the new order? The first element becomes the last, second element becomes second last, and so on. Okay. So reverses the internal order of all elements in list. Okay. Example, I'm writing A equal to, this is your original list, A dot reverse. And if you print and see the list, now this is also like sort. It is going to do changes on the original list. It doesn't return a copy. Reverse also does the same thing. It does the it reverses the internal order of the original list. It doesn't return your copy. Okay, see. For example, suppose this is our list. Okay, and I'm writing L dot reverse. And then if we print and see, the internal order is changed. This Hari, John, Sita, Ram, Jack, that way. Okay, but using reverse method, you are doing it. But you can do it by L square bracket colon colon minus 1 also. Getting? I hope this, when I told you in the previous lecture, that in the previous lecture only, how to access elements of the list by using index, then start and end, start, end, step. Okay? So if you don't give start and end entire list, and minus 1 means it will start taking step in the minus 1 gap. So Bill, Bob, Tim, that way it will give. Getting? So that is also possible. Only the difference is with this, it just returns a copy, which is a reversed. Original list remains as it is. Getting? So in this case, the original list is not reversed. It returns a reverse list as a copy. The original list remains as it is. Okay? So I hope you are understanding about sort and reverse. Is it right, all of you? Any queries regarding sort and reverse? And sorted method also. Sorry, sorted built-in function. Sort as a method and sorted as a built-in function. Okay? Right, all of you? Just give me confirmation.
Yes.
Sure. Now, many more methods to learn. Okay. Now, next methods which we are going to discuss now. Now, next two, three methods. They are all concerned related to removing elements from the list. Okay. So, if you want to remove any element from the list, then there are two, three provisions given. All one by one we are going to see. Okay. The first provision is using pop method. Pop will by default remove the last element from the list if you don't give this index. If this index is not provided, the pop will remove the last element in the list and return also that deleted element. Whatever element is deleted, it will return. Okay, and it will remove also from the original list. Means your original list is reduced by one element. And suppose if you give index, then it's going to delete the element from the given index. Okay, so if you are providing index, now that index can be from 0, so it will consider from right side, sorry, left side. If you give negative, it will consider from right side, that you know now. Okay, but if you provide index, it's going to remove the element from the given index. Okay, and that deleted element it returns as well. Okay, so whichever element is deleted, it will return also. Okay, so hope you're understanding pop method. We'll quickly try to apply. Like, this is your original list. For example, we'll assume this is the list. Print L dot pop, suppose I'm not giving index, so by default it will remove the last element, that is Hari will get deleted. It will return also that deleted element, C, that is getting printed. And now if you check your list will be with one element less. Getting? Is it having Hari now? No. Okay. And you can remove on the basis of index as well. L dot pop, and suppose I give 3. Okay, so who is at the third place? 0, 1, 2, 3. So Tom is at the third place. The third place element will get deleted. It will return also that deleted element, that is Tom. And if you try to check your original list, in that Tom is not present. Tom is getting, Tom is being deleted. So now if you see your original list, in that Tom is not present. And suppose if you give index, which is an invalid index, it will throw an exception. Okay, like suppose I'm saying L dot pop 15. So at 15th index, there is no element only. So it will throw index error. Getting? See, index error, pop index out of range. Right? So index error is also one type of exception. Remember, okay. To be studied in chapter 6, we are going to learn all these exception types. Okay, so index error is one type of exception, and why that index error is being thrown, because you are going to access any element in the list which is beyond its limit, whatever its limit, beyond the limit you are trying to access it. Okay, I hope you are clear with it. See, removes the element at the given index from your list which is invoking it. Whichever list is invoking this pop method, from that list it will remove element from the given index. The element which is removed is returned also, returns the removed element. Okay, and if you don't give index, so by default it's going to delete the last element. So if index is not mentioned, then removes the last element. Okay, I hope you are clear with it. Quick example, suppose A equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. This is your list. A dot pop 2 when I write. So 0, 1, 2. Who is at second place? 30. 30 will get deleted. It will return also that deleted element. So here what will get displayed? 30. If you print and see list, 10, 20 and 40 will be there. Okay. And if I write a dot pop and I'm not giving the index, so by default it will remove the last one, that is 40. एंड इफ यू चेक योर लिस्ट 40 इज नॉट देयर, तो 10 एंड 20, ओके. एंड इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू डिलीट अ एलिमेंट विच इज डिलीट एन एलिमेंट हुज इंडेक्स इज नॉट विद इन द लिमिट, तो नाउ इंडेक्स एरर एंड इट विल गिव पॉप इंडेक्स आउट ऑफ रेंज. गेटिंग? ओके, तो आई होप इट इज क्लियर. दैट इज पॉप. नाउ देयर इज अनदर वे ऑल्सो ऑफ रिमूविंग आइटम फ्रॉम द लिस्ट, ओके, बाई यूजिंग डेल स्टेटमेंट. डेल इज अ स्टेटमेंट, रिमेंबर. डेल इज नॉट अ फंक्शन, इट्स अ लैंग्वेज कंस्ट्रक्ट. लाइक लैंग्वेज हैज प्रोवाइडेड यू सम कंस्ट्रक्ट्स लाइक इफ, इफ एल्स, राइट, लूप्स, व्हाइल लूप, फॉर लूप. दीज आर द लैंग्वेज कंस्ट्रक्ट्स. तो सेम वे दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड वन लैंग्वेज कंस्ट्रक्ट कॉल्ड डेल. ओके, तो यूजिंग डेल ऑल्सो यू कैन डिलीट एलिमेंट फ्रॉम द लिस्ट. ओके, सपोज दिस इज योर ओरिजिनल लिस्ट, तो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डिलीट एनी एलिमेंट, डेल स्टेटमेंट ऑल्सो कैन बी यूज. डेल एल ऑफ एन इंडेक्स यू हैव राइट. ओनली द थिंग इज एज इट्स अ कंस्ट्रक्ट, इट्स नॉट अ फंक्शन. ओके, डज इफ रिटर्न समथिंग, डज फॉर लूप रिटर्न समथिंग? नो, नो, दे आर लैंग्वेज कंस्ट्रक्ट. तो सेम वे डेल इज अ लैंग्वेज कंस्ट्रक्ट, तो इट डजेंट रिटर्न एनीथिंग बट इट विल परफॉर्म दैट ऑपरेशन, दैट इज एल ऑफ इंडेक्स. तो इट्स गोइंग टू रिमूव एलिमेंट फ्रॉम योर लिस्ट फ्रॉम द गिवन इंडेक्स, ओके, बट डजेंट रिटर्न इट. एंड इफ यू चेक योर लिस्ट, इन दैट लिस्ट द एलिमेंट एट दैट इंडेक्स इज डिलीटेड और रिमूव. ठीक है, सी डेल लिस्ट ऑफ इंडेक्स. ओनली द डिफरेंस इज आफ्टर डिलीटिंग एल ऑफ थ्री. सपोज आई एम राइटिंग, तो 0, 1, 2, 3, एट थ्री प्लेस टॉम इज देयर, तो टॉम विल गेट डिलीटेड बट इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू रिटर्न. नाउ इफ यू चेक एंड सी योर लिस्ट, इन दैट टॉम इज एब्सेंट. गेटिंग? हियर ऑल्सो इंडेक्स एरर विल बी रेज्ड इफ यू गिव इनवैलिड इंडेक्स, लाइक एल ऑफ 15, वेर 15 इंडेक्स इज ओनली नॉट प्रेजेंट. ओके, तो हियर ऑल्सो इट जनरेट्स एन एक्सेप्शन, दैट इज इंडेक्स एरर. List assignment index out of range. Clear? Okay. So I hope it is clear, this method also. See, element to be deleted is mentioned using list name and the index. Means from which position you want to delete it, you give the position. So list square bracket index and give it to del. Quick example, A equal to 10, 20, 30, del A of 2, so at second place 30 is present, that 30 will get deleted, and if you check your list, in that 30 won't be there. And del A of 6 when I write, so 6th index is not there only, so again it's going to generate an error, but it is index error. Okay, list assignment index out of range. Clear? Okay, I hope it is clear to you. There is one more method of removing, that is called remove method. But remove removes not on the index base, it removes on the element base, value base. Getting? So if you don't know the position of the element which you want to remove, but you know the element, means you know that in my list Jack is present, but you are unaware about the position of Jack, then you can use L dot remove and pass element to it. Index, it's not index base. Here we are not passing index, we are passing element. I hope you are trying to make the concept clear. It is element base. Obviously, remove will be slower than pop. Pop is on the index base. So going to the particular index directly is easy. Getting? Why? Because they are continuous. So if continuous means that objects are kept anywhere, but their references are kept in that list in a continuous form. So suppose I want to go to third place. So if I know the start, so direct offset I can take and come to that place. Because I know everyone will take fixed size. So if this is going to take 4, 4, 4, 4. तो टू रीच टू थर्ड प्लेस, तो फ्रॉम स्टार्ट 3 into 4 इफ यू डू, तो यू विल गेट डायरेक्टली द एड्रेस ऑफ एड्रेस और द रेफरेंस ऑफ दैट पोजिशन. तो पोजिशन बेस्ड एक्सेसिंग और पोजिशन बेस्ड डिलीटिंग इज ऑलवेज फास्टर. बट एनी वे, वेन यू डोंट नो द पोजिशन ऑफ द एलिमेंट बट यू नो द एलिमेंट, देन यू कैन यूज द अदर वन, दैट इज रिमूव. रिमूव एंड पास एलिमेंट. इट विल सर्च दैट एलिमेंट, इफ फाउंड इट विल डिलीट इट. ओके, अदरवाइज हियर ऑल्सो इट विल थ्रो एन एक्सेप्शन. इट विल नॉट थ्रो इंडेक्स एरर, इट विल गिव यू अ वैल्यू एरर. इट विल से दैट एलिमेंट नॉट फाउंड. ओके, तो रिमूव मेथड ऑल्सो इज क्लियर टू यू. लाइक आई जस्ट गिव यू द इलस्ट्रेशन ऑफ रिमूव. सी एल एल डॉट रिमूव. रिमूव वॉन्ट रिटर्न एनीथिंग. ओके, बट इट विल रिमूव इट. एज पॉप रिटर्न्स द डिलीटेड एलिमेंट, रिमूव डजन. लाइक हियर आई एम राइटिंग एल डॉट रिमूव टॉम. ओके, रिमूव डजन रिटर्न एनीथिंग. बट नाउ इफ यू चेक एल, इन दैट टॉम इज एबसेंट. इज टॉम प्रेजेंट? नो. बट इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू रिमूव समथिंग विच इज नॉट प्रेजेंट, ठीक है, तो एज इन दिस लिस्ट कृष्णा इज एबसेंट, इट विल थ्रो एन एरर. सी वैल्यू एरर, एक्स नॉट इन लिस्ट. लिस्ट डॉट रिमूव एक्स, एक्स नॉट इन लिस्ट. एक्स इज द पैरामीटर, तो इट इज टेलिंग दैट कि दैट एक्स इज नॉट इन द लिस्ट. एग्रीड? आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू यू गाइस. सी तो लिस्ट डॉट रिमूव एंड गिव योर एलिमेंट, डिलीट्स एलिमेंट फ्रॉम लिस्ट. तो विद इन योर लिस्ट इट विल सर्च दैट एलिमेंट. इफ द एलिमेंट इज फाउंड, ओके, इट विल डिलीट इट, डजेंट रिटर्न एनीथिंग. एंड इफ इट इज नॉट फाउंड, इट विल जनरेट अ वैल्यू एरर. ठीक है, सी ए इक्वल टू 10, 20, 30, 40, दिस इज योर लिस्ट. ए डॉट रिमूव 20, 20 इज प्रेजेंट, देयरफॉर इट विल डिलीट इट. नाउ इफ यू चेक योर ए, तो इट विल बी 10, 30, 40. ओके, एंड ए डॉट रिमूव 100 व्हेन आई राइट, तो 100 इज एबसेंट इन योर लिस्ट, तो इट विल थ्रो वैल्यू एरर. लिस्ट डॉट रिमूव एक्स, एक्स इज नॉट इन लिस्ट. ठीक है, तो टिल हियर आई होप इट इज क्लियर. ओके, देन देयर इज वन मोर प्रोविजन. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मेक योर लिस्ट कंप्लीट एम्प्टी, ओके, एज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रिमूविंग, तो वी हैव डिस्कस थ्री वेज ऑफ रिमूविंग एन एलिमेंट. वन पॉप, सेकेंड डेल स्टेटमेंट, थर्ड रिमूव मेथड. देन इफ सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू मेक योर लिस्ट एम्प्टी, ऑल द एलिमेंट्स यू वॉन्ट टू रिमूव फ्रॉम इट, ओके, तो देयर इज वन मेथड कॉल्ड क्लियर. ठीक है, सपोज दिस इज योर लिस्ट एंड नाउ आई एम प्रिंटिंग द लिस्ट. नाउ आई एम राइटिंग एल डॉट क्लियर. All the elements deleted, but the list exists. It will show you empty list. See, open square, close square. Okay, so clear method. I hope you got it. And suppose you want to destroy your list, the list only should get destroyed. Means all the elements also will get deleted and the list also will be destroyed. Means here what is happening, only the elements are deleted. The list exists as an empty list. But suppose you don't want that list also to exist. Clear? Means from the symbol table, the entry with the name L also should go. Getting? Means there should not be an object only with the name L exist. Okay? So for that you have tried del only, but give the list object. See, del L. Now if I try to print L, it won't show empty list. It will give you a name error. It will say there is no object only with the name L, because it has deleted that object only. So when it has deleted the object, from the symbol table, a entry with the name L is also removed. See, print L when I write. Name error. Name L is not defined. Can you see? Name error, name L is not defined. Why? because it has deleted the entry only with the name L from the sim tab. So we don't have only an object with the name L existing. ठीक है? तो होप इट इज क्लियर, यस और नो? ओके, क्विकली विल गो थ्रू द स्लाइड. तो लिस्ट डॉट क्लियर रिमूव्स ऑल द एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम द लिस्ट, दैट इज मेक्स द लिस्ट एम्प्टी. ए इक्वल टू 10, 20, 30, प्रिंट ए, इट विल डिस्प्ले दिस. ए डॉट क्लियर, एवरीथिंग गॉन. नाउ इफ यू प्रिंट एंड सी, इट विल शो यू एम्प्टी लिस्ट, राइट? ओके, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट कॉपी ऑफ अ लिस्ट, ओके, तो फॉर दैट नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस. तो टिल हियर अबाउट रिमूविंग, यू गॉट इट? तो रिमूविंग लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स आई टोल्ड यू, लाइक पॉप, डेल, देन रिमूव, क्लियर, एंड डिस्ट्रॉइंग द एंटायर लिस्ट ऑल्सो यू कैन डू बाई डेल स्टेटमेंट, डेल एंड द लिस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट. ठीक है? तो टिल हियर इट इज क्लियर टू यू ऑल ऑफ यू? जस्ट गिव मी कंफर्मेशन. श्योर ना? ओके, वंस यू रिकॉल इट अगेन अगेन व्हेन यू रीड इट और रिकॉल, तो आई होप इट विल बी नॉट दैट डिफिकल्ट. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट. नेक्स्ट, सी, इफ यू क्रिएट वन लिस्ट एंड इफ यू आर जस्ट असाइनिंग दैट टू सम अदर ऑब्जेक्ट, लाइक हियर यू आर क्रिएटिंग वन लिस्ट 10, 20, 30, एंड नाउ इफ यू गिव इट दैट एल टू सम पी, ओके, पी इक्वल टू एल, राइट? नाउ इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी फील एज इफ कि वन मोर लिस्ट इज क्रिएटेड. दिस एल इज योर ओरिजिनल लिस्ट एंड वेन यू जस्ट असाइन दैट लिस्ट टू अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट, वॉट हैपन्स इज पी डजन गेट क्रिएटेड एज अ न्यू क्लोन लिस्ट. पी डजन बिकम अ न्यू कॉपी लिस्ट. इंस्टेड ओनली द रेफरेंस इज कॉपीड. तो पी ऑल्सो इज रेफरिंग टू द सेम लिस्ट वेर एल इज रेफरिंग. तो इफ एल मेक्स द चेंजेस, चेंजेस आर सीन टू पी, और इफ पी मेक्स चेंजेस, द चेंजेस आर सीन टू एल, और इफ यू प्रिंट एंड सी द एड्रेसेस, द एड्रेसेस प्रिंटेड आर ऑल्सो सेम. गेटिंग? मीनिंग हियर द एक्चुअल डुप्लीकेट इज नॉट क्रिएटेड. When you copy, when you assign one list to another list, so what Python does is Python doesn't actually create a copy. Getting? It will just copy the reference. So pictorially, I'll just try to tell you that one list is created already with value 10, 20, 30. But that 10, 20, 30 are themselves also object, no? Of class integer. Now you should know it. In Python, everything is an object. So this is also an object, object, object. So there is an object, integer object with value 10. There is another integer object with value 20. Another integer object with value 30. And all these objects also will have their references. They are kept in this list, which is also actually an object. And that object's reference is with L. क्लियर? तो एल कंटेन्स द रेफरेंस ऑफ दिस लिस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दैट लिस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट कंटेन्स द रेफरेंस ऑफ मेनी इंटीजर ऑब्जेक्ट्स. तो यू हैव मेनी इंटीजर ऑब्जेक्ट्स, ऑल दैट इंटीजर ऑब्जेक्ट रेफरेंसेस आर इन वन लिस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट एंड दैट लिस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट रेफरेंसेस इन एल. बट वेन यू असाइन पी इक्वल टू एल, वन मोर एंट्री इन द सिंबल टेबल इज डन एंड ओनली द रेफरेंस इज कॉपीड हियर. P also refers to the same list. P doesn't refer to a sep. Here, in short, when we say P equal to L, it doesn't create a duplicate list. You understanding? A duplicate list is not created. Only new entry in same tab and the reference is same copied. So P and L both are referring to the same list. Get it? So if L does any changes, the changes are seen to P, or if P does any changes, the changes are seen to L. और इफ यू प्रिंट एंड सी देयर एड्रेसेस दे बोथ विल बी सेम गेटिंग ओके सी आई ट्राई टू जस्टिफाई तो नाउ व्हेन आई राइट पी इक्वल टू एल ओके एंड आई प्रिंट एल एंड पी बोथ द लिस्ट आर सेम इनिशियली ओके इफ आई राइट एल डॉट अपेंड 40 तो व्हेन आई अपेंड 14 एल दैट 40 इज सीन टू पी ऑल्सो बिकॉज दे आर नॉट डिफरेंट एक्चुअली दे आर वन एंड द सेम थिंग सी ओके और इफ पी डॉट इंसर्ट 1,15 सपोज तो एट वंथ प्लेस दैट इज 20th प्लेस 15 कम एंड नाउ इफ आई राइट प्रिंट एल कॉमा पी ओके तो 15 इज नॉट ओनली इंसर्टेड इन पी इट इज विजिबल टू एल ऑल्सो कैन यू सी इन बोथ बिकॉज एक्चुअली दे आर नॉट डिफरेंट दे आर वन एंड द सेम थिंग यू कैन थिंक लाइक दैट कि हाउस इज वन एंड देर आर टू कीज ऑफ द हाउस एंड यू कैन हैव एक्सेस दैट हाउस बाय बोथ द कीज ओके तो हियर द लिस्ट इज वन ओनली बट यू कैन एक्सेस दैट लिस्ट बाय एल ऑल्सो एंड पी ऑल्सो क्लियर ओके इवन व्हेन यू प्रिंट एंड सी देयर एड्रेसेस आई डी ऑफ एल एंड आई डी ऑफ पी You'll see that their addresses are same. Getting? Are they different? No. Right? So this proves that when you assign one object to another, a duplicate is not created. A copy is not created. Clear? A clone doesn't get created. Rather, only the reference is copied. Okay? So now then, what to do? If I want a duplicate, I don't want this way. The reference should not get copied. Getting? What should happen is a complete duplicate should get created. Okay? And in that duplicate, so actually this duplicate doesn't take place. It will also refer here only. But anyway, this list and this list is treated differently. So we will imagine this way. Actually 10, 20, 30 doesn't get duplicated. Okay? It's not deep copy. It is just shallow copy. Okay? But I'm just trying to tell you like this. Okay, suppose I want this thing. A new list should get created. In that also the same elements should be there which are there in your original list. Elements of original list same in this duplicate list. And now this duplicate list reference is kept in P. Clear? Okay. Now both are referring to their own list. Initially they are exactly same. That is what cloning, clone concept of when twins are born. Like, so initially they look very much same. But as they go on growing, they independently change. Sometimes like one among the twins, one eats too much. One doesn't eat. So one look thin, one look fat. So it doesn't matter. Clear? What I want to say, later they can change. Okay? Forever they cannot look same. So initially when the clone is created, they both have same element. But later L can change itself. But when L change, no effect to P. Or if P change, no effect to L. Or even if you check their addresses, they will be different. Getting? So how to do this? So for that there is one copy method. L dot copy. Copy is a method. Okay. So what will L dot copy do? Create a duplicate of L. Means it will allocate separate memory for a new list. All the elements what are there in L are put into this duplicate list. Clear? All the elements of your original list are put into this duplicate list. And the reference of that duplicate list, this copy method returns, which you can collect in P. Getting? So L.copy, what it's going to do? It will create a complete duplicate list of L and then return the reference of that copy list or duplicate list. And if you check the addresses of L and address of P, they won't be same. Getting? But initially the content of L and P will be सी। ओके, तो होप इट इज क्लियर, वी विल गो थ्रू इट। इनिशियली आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट कि असाइनिंग वन लिस्ट टू अनदर डजंट एक्चुअली क्रिएट अ डुप्लीकेट। ठीक है, सी, सिंपली असाइनिंग लिस्ट वन टू लिस्ट टू वोंट क्रिएट कॉपी ऑफ लिस्ट वन, ओनली रेफरेंस विल बी कॉपीड। एग्रीड? असाइनिंग लिस्ट वन टू लिस्ट टू डजंट क्रिएट अ कॉपी ऑफ लिस्ट वन। ओके, इट विल जस्ट कॉपी द रेफरेंस ऑफ लिस्ट वन एंड लिस्ट टू, दैट इज लिस्ट वन एंड लिस्ट टू बोथ विल रेफर टू सेम मेमोरी लोकेशन। क्लियर? बोथ आर रेफरिंग टू द सेम, ओनली द एड्रेसेस आर कॉपीड। सी, वी विल ट्राई टू जस्टिफाई इट। तो चेंजेस मेड टू लिस्ट वन विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड इन लिस्ट टू एंड वाइस वर्सा। इट हैज टू बी, वाई? बिकॉज दे आर नॉट टू डिफरेंट लिस्ट, दे आर वन एंड द सेम, दे आर जस्ट टू रेफरेंसेस रेफरिंग टू द सेम मेमोरी। ठीक है, लाइक इन सी यू कैन से दे आर टू पॉइंटर्स बट बोथ आर पॉइंटिंग टू द सेम मेमोरी। तो यू हैव क्रिएटेड पॉइंटर पी, यू हैव क्रिएटेड पॉइंटर क्यू, बट इन बोथ पॉइंटर द एड्रेस केप्ट इज सेम, देयरफॉर बोथ आर पॉइंटिंग टू सेम मेमोरी। सी टर्मिनोलॉजी, एग्जैक्ट सेम इज हैपनिंग हियर। ओके, सी, विल जस्ट ट्राई टू जस्टिफाई फर्स्ट, ओके, हाउ इट इज वर्किंग। तो ए इक्वल टू 10, 20, 30, दिस इज योर ओरिजिनल लिस्ट, यू आर प्रिंटिंग इट, यू आर असाइनिंग ए टू बी, तो बी विल जस्ट कंटेन द रेफरेंस ऑफ ए, देयरफॉर व्हेन यू प्रिंट बी यू विल सी द सेम लिस्ट, व्हेन यू प्रिंट द एड्रेसेस आर सेम, व्हेन द एड्रेसेस आर सेम दैट इट्सेल्फ प्रूव्स, ओके, व्हेन द एड्रेसेस आर सेम दैट इट्सेल्फ प्रूव्स दैट द कॉपी इज नॉट क्रिएटेड, ओनली द रेफरेंस इज कॉपीड। यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग अनो? Actually, this much is also sufficient to justify that assigning one object to another object doesn't create a copy. Only the reference is put. Getting? So now when I write A dot append 60, A dot append 60, so 60 will get added, but it will be visible to both. See, when you print A and when you print B, both print the same thing. Or through B, if I am trying to replace this 10 with 5, see, B of 0 equal to 5. I think we have discussed all this in the previous session, changing any element and all. So you can do B of 0 equal to 5. So at 0th place, this 10 is going to get replaced by 5. But if you print A and B, in both lists you will see 5. Getting? Okay? I hope you got it. But now, our intention is not this. We don't want like this. We want what should get created. An exact duplicate. Right? A separate memory is to be allocated. And in that separate memory, the elements of your original list should be same in that duplicate list. But both will have different address. Okay? So in reality, I'm showing like this. But list created are two, but the elements in that list are same only actually. Okay, it refers here only. This I hope you should recall it in chapter 2 when I told that in one scope you cannot have two objects with same value. You remember, no? It checks in the pool. Okay, if there is an object with 10. Now next time if again you are doing some assigning with 10. So already in pool it's there. So it will just add an entry and it will refer to the same. Here also exact same. This list and this list created is different. Getting or no? The list created is different. But inside that, the objects are same. But anyway, like when you try to add something in L, it will get added in L, not here. Or when you try to add in P, it will get added in P. Not there. Getting? Clear? And the addresses are different. Okay? The copy method will return copy, that is the clone or duplicate of your original list. List which is invoking it. Okay? See, A equal to 10, 20, 30, B equal to A dot copy. Now, B and A will contain same element.
inside A also, inside B also. The elements are same, right? But their addresses are different because they are totally duplicate. Okay? Now see, if you print and see A and B, it will print 10, 20, 30, 10, 20, 30. But if you print and see their addresses, A address, B address. Okay? So A address, B address is different. Is the address same? No. Clear? And if I add 40, it's going to add 40 in this A. In B, no change. Getting? See, when you print AB, 40 is in A, but in B, nothing is there. Okay, I hope it is clear. Now there is another way also of creating a clone by using list function. Ideally it is a constructor, but now instead of talking in terms of OOP language, I'm just saying it is a function. L is the original list, P equal to list of L. This way also you can do. So list at current, in current context I am talking about, list is a function which takes one list and gives you the duplicate of that list. Duplicate, it will create a new list in which it will put all the elements of L and return you the duplicate list reference. Getting? So this way also you can do, or using copy method also. Clear? Okay. Now about copy, I didn't give a demonstration. I'll give you P equal to L dot copy. Now initially if you print L and P, both the list will be same. Okay? But L dot append, if I write 50 and I try to print L and P, you can see 50 is put in only first list. The second list is as it is. Can you see? 50 is added in L, it is not added in P. Okay? And vice versa. If you add something in P, the changes won't be seen in L. Suppose L of 0, you are making 5. So that 0th element is becoming 5 only of P, not L. P of 0 equal to 5. See, so that 0th element has become 5, not this one. Okay, and no need to do also so many things. Actually this one thing is also sufficient. When you print ID of L and P, ID of L and ID of P, that itself shows different address. Does it show same address? No. So as the address itself printed is different, here itself it proves what? They are different. Okay? And cloning, I said, you can do it by which function also? List function. Actually, we say list is a function, but it is a constructor. Actually, constructors are also methods only. Right or no? They are magic methods which get called automatic. Same list, and then you can pass L. And now print and check their addresses, ID of P and ID of L. Okay? It will print different address. Can you see? As the addresses printed are different, this itself proves that list function also returns a copy of your given list. Okay? So list and list one. So it takes list one and gives you the duplicate of it. Okay, it returns a complete duplicate. Okay, so list built-in function returns copy, right? Returns copy, that is the clone of your list one. A equal to 10, 20, 30, B equal to list of A. You print and see both the list, and when you print and see the addresses are different. Okay, hope it is clear, right? Okay, then there is only one part. Okay, so till here it is clear to you, creating duplicate, cloning, cloning can be done by two ways, either by using copy method or by using list function also. Right, all of you? Please give me confirmation.
Yeah.
Yep.
Sure, no? Okay, quite easy concept. Actually, data structure itself is easy because here everything already they have done. We are just understanding the methods, okay, and the functions, whatever they have given, right? And to be used appropriately, right? In generally in your machine learning and all, if you are planning for machine learning, their abundant use of data structures is there, okay? So this part is clear. Then about joining, we are going to see. You can concatenate two lists. Like if you're having one list and you're having another list, not necessary both are to be of same length or anything. You can directly write L1 plus L2. Actually, plus is being overloaded. Means plus is given some more functionality. Plus is having its natural work as adding two integers or adding floats and booleans. Between them, it will do the addition. Or if it is there are two strings, then it will do the work of concatenation. So plus, or if there are two complex numbers, to add two complex numbers. So that is its natural work. So plus does the work of adding. Now, if the same plus you are using on list, it will do the concatenation of the list. So it will create a new list containing all the elements of L1 followed by all the elements of L2. Getting? But now, directly plus we are able to apply on list means, is there some magic method getting called implicitly? Yes. Okay. So there is one magic method going to get called for doing this addition. And that magic method returns you a new list containing all the elements of first list followed by second list. Okay, see, print L3. It gives you all the elements of first list followed by all the elements of second list. Clear? Okay.
If I did B and C concatenated into L3.
No, it has, what it has done is, it has made it of equal length. No, the length, it has made the length equal.
So it will always concatenate to the middle numbers or...
Me too encountering for the first time, that's the reason. Wait, I'll tell you. I guess the length is different. L3 equal to L1 plus L2. So the overlapping length L3. No, I have done mistake. I have not put comma. Very sorry. That's what I was telling you everything right and what I'm doing here. Here I have not put comma. This is considered as one element. Got it, na? All of you.
Yeah.
So actually it doesn't do like that because I'm been telling from so many batches that plus does the concatenation and it puts all the elements of first list followed by second. Getting? It won't do like that. 10, 20, 30, A, B, C, D only you will get it. Getting? It was my mistake. I forgot to put comma and then you also didn't observe that. See. Getting? So it is nothing complicated. Plus when we do, it is going to take the elements of first list followed by second list. That simple it is. Clear? Here what happened is, I just wrote B and C and I didn't put space, sorry, comma. So, I treated this as one element only, that is BC. Got it, na? Yes or no?
Yes.
So that was not a, that was my side mistake. I was not putting comma over here. Otherwise, it's very simple. It will put all the elements of first list followed by second. Nothing. No such a rule. Okay? Nothing length rule or anything. Getting? Simple it is. First list followed by second list. And actually, there one magic method gets called L1 dot double underscore add double underscore. It has to be a dunder method. Why? Because when I'm telling that ki here one magic method is called, so you know every magic methods are dunder method according to Python rule. What are magic methods? Methods which get called implicitly. You don't have to call it. Here, see, did we call? No. Okay, then also here this dunder method is called. So it's a magic method. It's a method which is going to get called implicitly. And every magic method are dunder method. Dunder means they are going to have double underscore at the beginning and end. See, you'll get the similar result. Similarly, same result. Getting? Okay, so you got it. So that simple the rule they have kept it. So to join two or more list, you can use plus operator. Plus is mean overloaded. When we say plus
Okay.
is overloaded, means is that plus given some extra work? Like plus is doing its natural work of adding scalar values like integers and float and boolean, even string for concatenation, complex for adding two complex number. So that it is doing. Okay, but now we are telling that please add to list also. So when we are giving some extra work, so that is called overloaded. But for overloading, we have to implement some methods. So already in class list, one method double underscore add double underscore is implemented. It takes one list as an argument and one is the invoker. See, this way. Here I've shown L1 dot add L2. So L2 is a parameter and L1 is the invoker. L1 is invoking and L2 is the parameter. Okay, so internally it will create a temporary list in which all the elements of L1 followed by L2, and then that new list, whichever temporary list is there, it returns which comes in L3. Okay, hope it is clear. Right, so this was all about list. ठीक है, आई होप इट इज क्लियर. सम टू थ्री फंक्शंस आई टेल यू, आई हैव नॉट मेंशनड अबाउट देम ऑन द लिस्ट, बट आई जस्ट गिव यू क्विक एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ इट. प्लीज रिमेंबर दोज फंक्शंस ऑल्सो. ओके, फंक्शंस दे आर बिल्ट इन फंक्शंस, दे आर नॉट मेथड. ओके, तो इन दैट वन इज ऑल. इफ यू हैव अ लिस्ट एंड इन दैट लिस्ट इफ ऑल वैल्यूज आर ट्रू, देन दैट फंक्शन विल रिटर्न ट्रू. सी लाइक एल 4.5, 4.5 इज इम्प्लिसिटली ट्रीटेड ट्रू. आई गेस इन पाइथन आई हैव टोल्ड इन चैप्टर 1 हु ऑल आर ट्रू एंड हु ऑल आर फॉल्स. इफ यू डोंट रिमेंबर, आई जस्ट रिकॉल इट. इंटीजर 0, फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट 0.0, ओके, देन कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर 0 प्लस 0 जे एंड एम्प्टी स्ट्रिंग. Empty string is, these all are false. These all values are considered as false. But everything other than this is true. Okay, so L 45 I'm writing, 6.2 I'm writing true. Okay, I'm writing empty string. I'm writing 0 plus 6j. Okay, then I'm writing 0.0. Now in this list, if each and every value is true, any नहीं, all, any I'm going to tell you next, ठीक है, all, and when I write L, all, L, तो does L contain all true values? Yes, then all will return true. If it contains any one value also which is not true, it will return false. तो 45 is true, 6.2 is true, true is true. Empty string false, therefore all will return false. Getting or no? Like, see, instead of empty string, if it contains Ram, and here instead of 0.0, if it is 0.5. And now if I check print all L, so does the list contain any false value? No, all are true. 45 is true, 6.2 is true, true is true only, RAM is true, 0 plus 6J is true, 0.5 is true. So all returns true. Clear? I hope you got it. And the complement of it is any. So what any does is, it checks whether any value is true. If any value is true, it will return true. Getting? Like L equal to 0.0 false, empty string, then 67, 0 plus 0 j. Okay, and I'm writing print any of all. So now in this L, at least some values are true. Okay, are all false? No, at least one is true. Therefore, you'll get answer true. Okay, but suppose this 67 is also not true if it is digit 0. And now I'm checking print any all. Now you'll get false because all are false. In any, at least one should be true for the result to come true. Agreed? I hope any and all is clear to you. Isn't it?
Yes.
Sure? Okay. Very good. And one more I'll tell you so that we can proceed further. Okay? Next is enumerate. Enumerate method will just return you the element and the index. Element and the index. Okay, means when you want to traverse the list, but you just don't want the element, you want the index as well. Correct? Okay, right? Like L equal to, it is containing some elements. Okay, and now I want to retrieve the element along with the index. Like I want 0 Ram, 1 Sita. So then you can use enumerate. Enumerate again returns one more iterable object, which is of class enumerate only. Okay, see, like if I write capital E, enumerate. Enumeration means only, in English, enumerate means listing everything one by one. Like for example, some day, like when you are taking your, you have decided to clean your room, okay, so you just remove all your items and put on the table in a very proper sequential manner. Getting? So you are just arranging them in a manner, and then you are giving numbering to it, the first element, my second object, third object, fourth object. So that process of listing is enumeration. Okay, so enumerate method, and I'll give L. It will return you one more object which will be of class enumerate. You understanding? Print, and if E you print, it will tell that it's an object of class enumerate. See, print type of E. See, class enumerate. So enumerate is a class also. And as it is a iterable category, enumerate also come under iterable category, like list and tuple and dictionary. So enumerate come under iterable. So you can use it in a for loop. Okay, like this, for x in E or x in enumerate. Here only you can write enumerate. It will return you first and which object? Enumerate L, if I write, so it will return you an enumerate object, an object of class enumerate, and that if you use in for loop, so one by one element from that enumerate object you'll get, which is also a iterable object. But that one by one element is again a tuple in the form index and the value, index and the value, like this 0 Ram, okay, 1 Sita, that way. So that each element which is going to come from that enumerate is one tuple with index element, index element. Okay, see, if you print it, does it give index and the element, index and the element, index element, okay, such tuples, and all these tuples are kept in one iterable object which is of class enumerate. So actually this E is containing all these pairs, getting like this, this one pair, second pair, third pair, they all are in one iterable object, and that whole iterable object is of class enumerate. And as it's a iterable, obviously it's allowed to use in the for loop. That is the speciality of Python, that Python allows you to use any iterable object in a for loop. Okay, so I hope you'll remember about enumerate also. Okay, and remember enumerate, any, all, they are not only for list, they are applicable for tuple also, they are applicable for set also, which will be learning in the future. Now, in the next subsequent topics, we are going to learn that only. Okay? So, hope it is clear to you guys. Right? All of you?
Yeah.
Okay. Then, moving on to the next data structure. So, this was all about list. Now, we'll move on to the second data structure, that is tuple. Okay, now the similarity between list and tuple is both are ordered collection of elements. Means in list also you will have list of elements which are ordered. Ordered means you can access them on the index basis, square bracket and the index you can give, and you can access the elements on the index basis. So both are ordered. List is also ordered collection, tuple is also ordered collection. Only one difference: tuple is immutable and list is mutable. List is mutable means you can do changes in the list, like you can insert element, you can append any element, right? You can append means add anything, you can extend also, like you can add elements of one list in another list. Even you can pop or you can remove or you can delete any element. All such operations are not supported for tuple. Therefore, tuple becomes very limited. Getting? Like tuple doesn't have all that facilities. Right? So tuple comes out to be very restricted. Okay? But anyways, wherever you want to pass a group of object, but you don't want to make allow any changes in that, to use tuple. So you are defining a function and then you are passing to it some group of object, and you want that within the function, that group of objects we should be able to access, but no change in that group. Then instead of passing list, pass. Okay, but tuple is also ordered. Okay, so tuple is collection of objects which are ordered, but it is unchangeable, whereas a list is changeable, other things are same. Okay, now we are going to discuss that how to create this tuple, then how to do different operations on tuple. Okay, so one by one that we'll discuss. You are able to hear me properly? Okay.
Yes,
no issue. I thought like some issue with the Wi-Fi, but no, it's working. Okay, coming back. So tuple basic definition you got to know. Okay, it is an collection of elements. Not necessarily they should be same, but generally we keep it same according to our application. Correct? So it is collection of elements, but it is unchangeable. Tuple is also ordered only, like list. So here also we have access on the index base. All that combinations which I gave, index and negative index and slice operator, start index colon int. Then even I gave you step count, that step. So all that facilities are applicable to tuple as well. Okay. Next, we are just going to see how to create a tuple. you have to create a tuple by listing out all the elements in a round bracket. Okay, so all the elements of the list you put it in a round bracket by separating it with a comma. Instead of square bracket, round bracket. So list is created by putting all the elements in a square bracket, whereas tuple is by listing all the elements in square. Okay. So tuple is in round and list is in square. I mean, I might have done something wrong, the opposite way I told. But tuple is created by listing all the elements in round. ठीक है? Now you can print and see this tuple. Okay, you can check its type. It will give that it is an object of class tuple. Like for list, it gives class list. So for tuple, it gives class tuple. So when it prints class tuple, that proves ki t is an object of class tuple. ठीक है? I hope it is clear to you. Only one thing you have to remember. Like if in your tuple there is only one value kept, t equal to bracket 10, it doesn't treat it as a tuple. Okay? It will consider it as an element of that type to which that object belongs. Like 10 belongs to int. So it will create t as an object of class int. Okay, I hope you are understanding. So it is no more a tuple, it is just an integer. See, you can check it. When I print t, it prints only 10, not round bracket 10. And when I check its type, it will give class int. See, class int. This will happen to any element when you put it only a single. Like here, if I put string Ram in a round bracket, it is not a tuple, it is a string object. See, print t. And if I check its class, it will give class str. So then in that situation, what to do? To put one extra comma over here. The moment I put comma, now it will be treating it as a object of class tuple. See, now if you print that tuple, then also okay, and if you check its type, it will say that it's an object of class tuple. Getting? Okay, so hope it is clear how to create it. And only this speciality, just remember that in a tuple, if you write only single element, so it will automatically create that object of that element type, not as a tuple. It doesn't create a tuple, instead it creates a object of that tuple type, that element type, whichever that element is. Okay, see, so now we'll first see creating a tuple. In Python, tuples are created by enlisting elements within a round bracket separated by comma, whereas list is created by enlisting all the elements in a square. And when we enlist, we separate by comma. Correct? See. So names equal to. Okay. Some names are put in it. Okay. Now names of our Hindu gods. And then I'm writing print names. It will print that tuple. And I'm writing print types of type of names. It will give class tuple. Okay, but if you create an empty list, names equal to empty tuple, no problem, it will be a tuple. For this, it is a tuple, empty tuple, names bracket. See, print names, round bracket. Type you check, it is tuple. But if your tuple contains only one element, names equal to round bracket, one element. So in that context, what happens is it doesn't create it as a tuple, rather it creates an object of that type. तो इफ इट इज स्ट्रिंग तो नेम्स बिकम्स अ ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ क्लास स्ट्रिंग. सी व्हेन आई से प्रिंट नेम्स इट प्रिंट राम नॉट राउंड ब्रैकेट राम. एंड व्हेन यू चेक इट्स टाइप इट प्रिंट्स क्लास टपल और क्लास str, क्लास str. बट इफ आई क्रिएट अ लिस्ट बाय जस्ट पुटिंग एन एडिशनल कॉमा तो इमीजिएटली नाउ इट इज टपल. क्लियर? सी नाउ द डिफरेंस. ठीक है, तो होप इट इज क्लियर क्रिएटिंग. श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू? ओके, देन मूविंग ऑन टू सम मोर थिंग्स लाइक एक्सेसिंग एलिमेंट्स ऑफ योर टपल. तो एक्सेसिंग एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द टपल इज एग्जैक्टली लाइक एक्सेसिंग एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम अ लिस्ट. इट इज वेरी मच नहीं, इट इज एग्जैक्टली सेम. ओके, तो ऑल द फैसिलिटीज विच आई टोल्ड ऑफ एक्सेसिंग इन लिस्ट द सेम थिंग इज एप्लीकेबल. तो क्विकली आई जस्ट रिकॉल इट हाउ टू एक्सेस एलिमेंट्स इन अ टपल. विल क्रिएट अ टपल. नाउ फॉर टाइमिंग फॉर सिंप्लिसिटी आई एम नॉट क्रिएटिंग अ डिफरेंट टाइप, आई एम जस्ट क्रिएटिंग इंटीजर्स. ओके, दिस इज वन टपल. नाउ इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एक्सेस यू कैन जस्ट राइट द टपल ऑब्जेक्ट स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट इंडेक्स. दैट सिंपल, टपल ऑब्जेक्ट स्क्वायर ब्रैकेट इंडेक्स. सो विच एवर एलिमेंट इज दैट इज प्रेजेंट एट दैट इंडेक्स प्लेस इट विल रिटर्न यू. आई होप इट इज यू आर एबल टू रिकॉल दिस. द सेम थिंग आई टोल्ड यू इन द लिस्ट केस ऑल्सो एग्जैक्ट सेम इज एप्लीकेबल. ओके, तो टी ऑफ इंडेक्स तो इट विल रिटर्न द एलिमेंट एट दैट इंडेक्स प्लेस. इफ यू आर गिविंग पॉजिटिव इंडेक्स तो इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम जीरो एंड जीरो इंडेक्सिंग मीन्स फ्रॉम लेफ्ट साइड. इफ यू आर गिविंग नेगेटिव इट स्टार्ट विथ माइनस वन एंड दैट इज फ्रॉम राइट साइड. ठीक है, गेटिंग ना? तो नाउ हियर इफ आई राइट प्रिंट टी ऑफ थ्री सपोज, तो जीरो वन टू थ्री, तो एट थर्ड प्लेस 40 इज प्रेजेंट, इट विल रिटर्न 40. ओके, एंड इफ यू गिव नेगेटिव इंडेक्स लाइक माइनस थ्री, तो माइनस थ्री मीन्स माइनस वन माइनस टू माइनस थ्री, तो 70 इज माइनस वन माइनस टू माइनस थ्री, तो हु इज एट माइनस थ्री? 50. क्लियर? बोथ वे पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव यू कैन गिव. हियर ऑल्सो इफ यू गिव इंडेक्स विच इज बियॉन्ड द लिमिट योर इंडेक्स एरर इज रेज्ड. सी टी ऑफ 10, बट देर इज नो एलिमेंट ओनली एट 10th इंडेक्स. इज देर एनी एलिमेंट एट 10th इंडेक्स? नो, तो इट विल थ्रो एक्सेप्शन इंडेक्स एरर, टपल इंडेक्स आउट ऑफ रेंज. देर इट यूज टू गिव लिस्ट इंडेक्स आउट ऑफ रेंज, हियर इट गिव्स टपल इंडेक्स आउट ऑफ रेंज. ठीक है, देन इफ यू वॉन्ट अ सब पार्ट ऑफ योर टपल विच इज अ कॉपी, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू गेट डिलीटेड फ्रॉम योर ओरिजिनल लिस्ट, ओनली इट विल रिटर्न अ कॉपी ऑफ दैट एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल टपल विच विल बी ऑल्सो अ टपल. इट विल बी अ सब टपल यू कैन से, बट ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ क्लास टपल ओनली इज पॉसिबल. तो वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज प्रिंट टी, गिव द स्टार्ट इंडेक्स कोलन एंड इंडेक्स एंड टेक केयर दैट एंड इज नॉट इंक्लूसिव, एंड इज एक्सक्लूसिव. ओके, सी तो आई गिव एन एग्जाम्पल. आई एम राइटिंग टी 2:5, तो इट विल गिव यू एलिमेंट फ्रॉम 2 इंडेक्स टिल 5 इंडेक्स. 5 इज एक्सक्लूसिव, तो 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, तो 5 इज एक्सक्लूसिव, तो इट विल स्टॉप 1 बिफोर, तो 30, 40 एंड 50. यू आर ऑल्सो सेम थिंग, इफ यू आर राइटिंग स्टार्ट इंडेक्स बट नॉट एंड, इट विल गो टिल एंड. तो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 2, दैट इज 0, 1, 2, 30, तो फ्रॉम 30 टिल एंड. इफ आई एम नॉट गिविंग स्टार्ट बट आई एम गिविंग एंड, तो इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 0. सी 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 एंड 5 इज नॉट देर, 5 is exclusive, so till 4 only it will stop. Getting? In this also you can give negative index. T of suppose minus 5 colon minus 2. Okay? So it will start at minus 5, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Okay? Minus 5, minus 4, minus 3. Minus 2 is exclusive. So only 30, 40, 50 will come. Okay? And suppose you want elements at some particular step. Only those elements you want. You can give, for that you have to give start, end, and then step. Okay, see, here I am writing T of 2 colon 7 colon 2. So it will start from second index 0, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 is not there anyway. So it is anyway going to stop at 6 because 7 is exclusive. And but here I gave step 3. Actually, my intention was step 2. You can give 3 as well. Okay. So start from 2. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only. 7 it won't take. 7 is exclusive. Now in this also at second, I mean, 2 step gap. So 30, 50 and 70. So it will return 30, then 50 and then 70. Okay. Hope it is clear. Step count can be negative also. Like if I write T colon colon minus 1, it will return with the reverse tuple. Okay. So these are all different ways of accessing tuple, which is exactly same like accessing elements from list. Okay, so quickly we'll see this, right? So you can access tuple items by referring to the index number inside square bracket. You write your tuple object, square bracket and an index. Okay, see, colors equal to red, blue, green, colors of 0. Okay, so who is there at 0th place? 0, red, right? And then you can give negative indexing also. I hope you know, negative indexing means begin from the right end, from the right side. So minus 1 refers to green, minus 2 to blue, minus 3 to green, sorry, red. Okay, so minus 1 refers to last item, minus 2 refers to second last, and so on. Tell me now, colors of minus 1, it is green. Then you can specify a range of index, that is start index and end index. Okay, so you can specify a range of index by specifying where to start and where to end the range. And specifying range, the return value will be a new list, a new tuple. It is not going to delete from the original tuple. Only the copy of that part is written, which is also a tuple. Okay. And when you give the start index, then the slice operator, and then the end index. End index is never inclusive. End is always exclusive. Okay. I hope clear to you. See, colors equal to, this is the list of colors. I am writing colors 2 colon 5. So 0, 1, 2. 2, 3, 4, 5 is exclusive. So green, yellow, pink. Only that much part will come as a tuple. Okay? Minus 4, minus 1. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. And minus 1. So from minus 4 till minus 1, but minus 1 exclusive. So it will stop here. That is black. Okay, to minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. To yellow, pink and black. Okay, got it. Till here it is clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, then quickly next part will do, and then we'll stop. One more part will take, that is change tuple values. Okay, so now already you know you cannot do changes in the tuple because tuple is immutable. As we could do it in a list, see, just to recall, when we created a list, okay, and if I want to change that 10 to 100, so we could write it by writing L of 0 equal to 100. So it used to replace on that 0th place 10, 100, and you print and see your list that 10 is changed to 100. But the same thing, if you try to do it for a tuple, it won't allow because tuple is immutable. See, T of 0 equal to 100, it will throw an exception. Okay, it will throw an exception. See, type error, tuple object does not support item assignment. Means on tuple you cannot do such assigning and replacing a value at particular index by new value. Get it? So in short, you cannot do directly changes in your tuple. Okay, but then there is one backdoor method. Okay, you can in a very technical term like hacking method. Okay, so what you can do is you can convert your tuple for time being to a list, do the changes in the list, and then again bring it back to tuple. You're getting clear? So for time being, what is to be done? Like in our Indian government, there are so many bylaws and laws. So just to do some wrong thing, you can take the benefit of that laws and misuse of it, and you can take the profit of that part, like, okay, which many people do. You might have observed it. Okay, same thing here. So you can take the benefit of it. You can convert that tuple into a list, change the list, and convert list back to tuple. So we'll feel as if the tuple is only changed, but ideally we have done so many things. So see, this is your original tuple. Okay, for time being I'm converting it to list, which is possible by using a list function. We have a list function. Okay, so you give your original list, sorry, tuple, and it will give you another copy of that tuple, which is a list. Address is different, huh? This T address and now new T address will be different because it has created a complete new clone of your T, but the tuple clone is a list one. Okay, now in this list at 0th place I'm keeping 100. It will allow because it's already a list. Okay, and then when I convert that back to tuple by using tuple constructor, see, you can convert it by using tuple conversion function. So now you're converting this list back to tuple and bringing in T again. And now if you check your T, it will be a tuple only, but in that the 10 is changed to 100, and the type also will be tuple. See, class tuple. Got it? I hope you got it. So this is just the fooling technique. We are taking that advantage ki we can convert a list to tuple and tuple to list, and that undue advantage, and we are doing this wrong thing. Clear? Ideally, directly you cannot modify any list. Okay? See, once a tuple is created, you cannot change its value. Why? Because that is the natural behavior of tuple, that tuple are immutable, that is, they are unchangeable. But as I said, you can do one thing: convert the list tuple to list, do changes in the list, and again convert back your list to tuple. Example I have shown, see, colors equal to red, blue, green. We have tried to change value at 1th index, that is blue, to white, but it throws an error. Okay, it will show type error and telling that for this type item assignment is not allowed. See, type error, type object does not support item assignment. then what to do? So as I said, convert your tuple to list by using list conversion function. Then add or replace value in that new list and convert that list back to tuple. Okay, convert that list back to tuple, and when you see your colors tuple again, in that oneth position instead of blue you'll be able to see white. Okay, so hope it is clear to you.